JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for June the 29th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but one of the other major currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained the most versus NZD, AUD and GBP, while it underperformed only against the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggests that markets turned to risk-off yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices traded in the red, and although sentiment improved somewhat during the US session, it deteriorated again today in Asia. In our view, the drive was once again comments by central bank officials, getting the ball rolling with the Eurozone and the ECB. Executive board member Fabio Panetta seemed to be in agreement with President Lagarde and chief economist Lane that monetary policy and fiscal policy support should not be withdrawn prematurely. However, Governing Council member Jens Widmann said that inflation is not dead and that he wants to discuss when emergency ends from a monetary policy point of view. He believes that running a pandemic emergency plan after the pandemic is over isn't honest. Widmann's remarks are certainly more hawkish than those of Lagarde, Lane and Panetta, and that's why European equities may have come under some selling interest. Later in the day, we heard from Richmond Fed President Thomas Barkin and Fed Board Governor Randall Quartz. Barkin said that he expects inflation to moderate over time to more normal levels, comments suggesting that he belongs to the camp of those wanting interest rates to stay low for a while longer. But Quarles noted that the labor participation doesn't need to return to pre-COVID levels because of baby boomer retirements. In our view, this can be translated as seeing the case for raising rates sooner as appropriate. So with his comments suggesting that he's another member in favor of raising interest rates, perhaps as early as next year, investors may now be becoming more concerned, and that's why risk appetite softened again today in Asia. As for our view, although we may see equities correcting lower and the dollar strengthening for a while more, we prefer to stick to our cautious stance and wait for more and clearer hints and clues as to how central bank officials intend to move forward. With that in mind, today we will get to hear again from ECB President Christine Lagarde and ECB Governing Council Jens Widmann. Although we already know their views on monetary policy, we may get more precise remarks on what may be the next moves of the Council as a whole. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, Germany's preliminary inflation data for June is due to be released. Both the CPI and the HICP rates are forecast to have declined to 2.3 and 2.1% year over year, from 2.5 and 2.4% respectively, something that may raise speculation that Eurozone's headline inflation due out tomorrow may slow down as well. Later in the day, from the US, we get the Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for the same month, which is expected to rise to 119 from 117.2. With regards to the energy market, we have the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.